from the earth's soil and clay, we were created in the likeness of his image, given a paradise called Eden, and he sits in the paradise of heaven. Holding his living breath betwixt the cages of our ribs, we are charged to do as Christ did. Pray unceasingly, fast sacrificially, and worship unquestionably, but how does his holy sanctity manifest in our everyday happenings? See, it is a folly to believe that we can transcendentally worship when the God of gods purged himself of himself, shoved it in human skin, and placed it in the womb of a virgin that you and I might identify with him. Yes. So there is no question. We must eminently exalt him. Study his walk of life, because your path probably won't lead to the pearly gates. Parallel your footprint with the Prince of Peace, and perhaps you will cross over into that sacred passageway. Prosperity theology got you worried about condos and Cadillacs when Jesus was the son of a poor man and rode into Jerusalem on a donkey's back. Sold out for 30 pieces of silver. Be clear, my brethren, money ain't the answer. Yes. See, your wealth will rot and moths will eat away your clothes, but I heard theology shapes anthropology, which orders society, and that blonde and blue-eyed Christ taught you that white is right and systems of oppression are insurmountable. But I'm guessing that you forgot that the bronze-skinned Jesus of Nazareth was the one to speak out against Roman injustice. Yes, yes.